गाइस वेदर माय स्क्रीन इज विजिबल।
यस मैम, यस।
वन मोमेंट, आई एम ट्राइंग वन न्यू थिंग, दैट्स व्हाट आई एम आस्किंग यू। ओके, सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू प्रैक्टिस टास्क फोर। राइट डाउन डिजाइन डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ सिमेट्री का।
जस्ट अ सेकंड।
इट इज देयर, द क्वेश्चन इज ऑलरेडी अपलोड guys, but for the class purpose only I'm just saying this to you. Just a moment. Now which slide is shown to you? Symmetry.
There's no change in slide.
Okay, yeah, the first heading slide only visible, no?
Yes ma'am.
Just a moment, I'll just give the question to you. Design different semi trigger configurations by using op-amp ICs. Okay, design different semi trigger configuration by using op-amp ICs 941. Also
Man,
find
the voice is breaking in between.
Breaking. Wait, I'll use the headphone. One moment. Okay guys, so is it clear now?
Yes ma'am.
Okay, so once again I'm repeating the question. The question is design different semi trigger configurations by using op-amp IC 741. Also find the hysteresis width for all mentioned configuration. So here what are the different configurations? Inverting, non-inverting, and semi trigger with bias compensation or bias. Okay, guys. In theory, we have learned that a semi trigger, which is nothing but regenerative comparator, right? We have seen that what we cannot in comparator and what we can do with semi trigger, or I can say that the comparator with positive feedback is called as semi trigger. One moment guys. Guys, just I'm asking you, the slide size is visible to you very small, or it's okay, the full screen view is visible to you? Guys?
Yes, ma'am.
Which one? The full screen mode or the small view is visible? Which one?
Full screen mode is visible, ma'am. Half screen.
Full screen is visible, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Means you can read the content, no?
Yes, ma'am. Like, it's we can read the content, ma'am.
Ha ha ha. That's fine then. Then look at the figure, guys. What we are going to find out at here. we are going to try different configuration of semi trigger, and there we are going to frame the hysteresis curve for all the type of semi trigger circuit, whether it is inverting or inverting or with bias compensation. We are going to frame the hysteresis curve for the semi trigger, and here you can see that, guys, how our signals are distorted when we are applying the input voltage and we want to get the pulse waveform, okay, from the semi trigger, because here we are using the positive feedback, okay. So what is the property of the semi trigger? It will compare and then only it will generate the output, okay, to the digital type. So this is our purpose at here, and here we are going to apply a sinusoidal input voltage of 2.5 volt with a frequency of 1 kilohertz, then we are going to generate the output, okay. So if this is comparator point of view, we may get our output is saturated at plus minus Vset. Here the Vset level is shown in the form of plus minus VCC. Wait, I'll change the slide for you. Okay, then if you derive the voltage equation at here to get the hysteresis value, you can refer this formula for the non-inverting semi trigger. Non-inverting semi trigger means here you can see that the input is applied to the non-inverting input of op-amp, as well as here we have used positive feedback. So how do we get our Vset level, guys, or the output voltage level? You may refer the formula how we have done that. So here Vin, if you want to figure out, because this is the Vin, this is nothing but how we are writing the V out equation, guys, normally for the op-amp. Guys, for the operational amplifier, how we are writing the V out equation? What is the V naught equation?
Gain into Vin.
Gain into Vin, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes, ma'am.
But now I need my Vin at here. So what should be the equation for from this figure point of view?
V in.
I want V in. What is my V in? I don't know. How do I find out? I have the power supply only plus minus 12 volt. Okay. And that I'm going to use. In that V out, I'm going to use the plus minus power supply voltages. So what should be my V in? It is shown in the slide itself, guys. You can watch the slide and at least.
Well, it's given.
Yeah, it is given.
Yes.
So it is for plus minus 12 volt. Suppose I will give the plus minus Vset is the plus minus 15 volt. At that time, what should be my V in? With this value of R1 and R2, R2 is nothing but RF and R1 is nothing but Rin.
But
because
is
we are finding the unknown V, how much V in?
7.5, ma'am, if 15 is given. V set.
15 is given. Yeah, so this is the way to calculate the applied input voltage for the semi trigger. Okay, let's consider this scenario, and one reverse case also I may give you that here in the hysteresis curve, you just see, guys, in this hysteresis curve, if you see the plus 12 is nothing but plus Vset minus Vset.
Nothing, ma'am.
Okay, Hemant, you are talking to self.
No, ma'am, actually, like, I thought hysteresis curve means something different, like it is on the same page, right?
yes, it is in the same page only. I'm telling you, na, it has shown in the figure. Actually, I cannot use my marker at here, that's what I have tried one different way of presentation, that I cannot use my marker. Wait, I'll use that type of presentation. I'll stop this one. Hmm. It is visible, right?
Yes, ma'am.
But still I cannot use my marker. That is the problem now. Wait, I'm trying to do that. Just a moment. These devices are very difficult, Ray, while taking the class. Support, it won't support means it's very difficult. 1 minute. Now it. Yeah, so this is your hysteresis curve. Okay, so see the limit. We got our applied input voltage in between plus minus 6 volt, right? From the given data, if you take R2 is 2K, R1 is 1K, the data may be different. Okay, then this is the range at which my input will be undistorted. So if it belongs to the positive VZ axis, what we are calling as per the theory, this is denoting which point and it's refer to which point. We are calling some particular name for this. Threshold voltage. Okay. So if we are calling this threshold voltage with respect to plus VZ, what we are calling V? UT, upper threshold voltage, right? And here what calling, at least you tell me, V of two threshold voltages are there, no? Upper threshold voltage and lower threshold voltage. So similarly, what do we say this one? Lower threshold voltage. What happened, guys? You are not answering? You don't know this or you don't want to express your answers. What is the issue? Tell me. Otherwise, I will pick you one by one and I will start asking. What do you want? Again, silence. What happened, guys? Tell me. Ritika, Dinesh, Srinidhi, Vikas, what happened?
Ma'am.
Nothing. Nothing. Then why you guys are not participating? You want me to deliver the lecture? No. You want me to be a robot, right? To just explain the concept and end the class, huh? You want me like that?
No,
you have to also participate in the discussion. No, then only it will be interesting for me to teach, huh? If you won't take part into the discussion, because this is lab, we have time. In theory class, I may not ask you. Okay, may not, but not all. So here at least you have to take part, no? Okay, anyway, see, here we are defining the VLT point and here we are defining the VUT point. U stands for upper threshold, LT stands for lower threshold. Okay, so this plus minus 6 volt is defining the range in terms of the V. But now I'm going to show you guys where you don't know the output voltage. There you have to calculate the upper threshold and lower threshold voltage. So how do we do that? This is the direct circuit I have shown. Okay. So this is what type of semi-trigger? We have three different type of semi-trigger, right? Inverting, non-inverting and semi-trigger with bias. By watching the circuit, can anybody answer me that this
non-inverting
particular semi-trigger belongs to which category?
Non-inverting.
Very good. This belongs to the non-inverting semi-trigger.
Ma'am, you said it was 12 volts, right?
No, that is for that example, whether I relate that.
Okay.
This is different case. Okay. That is first case I have shown where the input is not known to you, but now the input is known to you, you have to find out the VUT and VLT point, okay, from the given data as well as from the practical point of view. You have to match your theoretical value as well as the practical value. You have to make a tabular column to fill the data after the calculations and observation, okay. Yeah, then come to the point. Here it is identified as this circuit belongs to non-inverting symmetrical. What are the two different important points you have to consider? You have to check, we have to give positive feedback. Means when we are placing the op-amp onto the environmental screen, there we need not to rotate the op-amp or we need not to mirror the op-amp vertically. That option first you have to do. Then second option, we have to give input towards the non-inverting input. These two important things we have to do while the inverting input is fully grounded. So what should be our observation? Let's see. The circuit components are two resistors of 27k and 1k. Here you may replace these two 10k and 1k also. Your output will be generated. No issue. Okay guys, so here you got your R2 value, R1 value and V in is known. What is the equation for what is the equation for VUT? If the plus minus VSAT is plus minus 15 volt, that you have to calculate theoretically as well as practically. Practically, why I am telling that practically, I'll show you that because I am saying you that this plus minus VSAT level or the threshold voltage level here I am giving to you is minus 15, but when you check your actual simulated output, it is not plus minus 15, it will be in between 14.86. I think this value it will come. Whatever your practical value of VUT, you have to take this value and you have to calculate your VUT and LT point. That is the point I am saying. The answer will little bit differ in terms of plus minus 15 and plus minus 14.86 volt. Okay. Okay. So in this way, you have to implement.
Ma'am, practical value for VUT, we are getting like 13.63, ma'am.
Where? If you are taking plus minus 15 volt.
Yes, ma'am. VUT, you are saying. Ma'am, how to calculate?
If you take 14.86. If you take 14.86,
ma'am, we have to take VSAT as 14.86, ma'am.
Ma'am, your R2 is 10k.
Any one value you just take, you have to proceed with your answer. No theoretical value, if you are taking 27, you go with same for. If you are taking 10, same value you have to use for the calculation.
Okay.
Why I am telling you this? No. For 15, obviously the value will differ as compared to 14.86. So how much difference is there for theoretical design as well as practical observation? That's the point of view to show you. Okay. While generating the square wave outform, you should realize that, no, how much output you are getting. So let's see some more circuit. Here 10k implementation is there. Guys, one more important observation. See, now I have not rotated my op-amp. So I have to use positive supply voltage for pin number 7 and negative supply voltage for pin number 4. This thing also you have to remember. So now minus VCC is down and plus VCC is off. Those who want to rotate and do, they can also do, but remember that we have to use positive feedback. So this is the implementation for the RF is 10k and same value. V input, V applied input is 2.5 volt frequency 1 kilohertz, while V offset is 0 and AC is also 0. Yeah, this is our target, guys. We have to draw. This is the explanation as I said to you. Practically, if you take the observation as 14.816, your calculation will be different than theoretically if you take, then also it will different. Then one more observation is there. This is the calculation point of view, right? Then from the graph, how much we reference you are getting, that also we have to observe. Okay, this thing I'll show you one demo for any one type. So this was the explanation regarding the non-inverting symmetrical and inverting symmetrical. Just interchange the node. It means apply the input in the negative input. Okay, and that time it will become the inverting symmetrical. Then the next, symmetrical with bias. This is also one important point, guys. If you do the inverting symmetrical, just additionally you have to use this bias compensating or this external bias at here. So how much value of bias has been implemented at here? 1.5 volt. I have already designed the non-inverting symmetrical, right? 27 and 1k value. In that, additionally, if you use this bias DC potential externally, then what are the changes you are going to observe? Here also, what is the V reference value, guys? We have to identify. So for that, you have to solve this equation by referring your theory notes. So if you have to equate this point, V set minus V reference by 27 is equal to V reference minus 1.5 volt divided by 1K. So from that, if you solve that reference, we may get 1.9 volt. So is 1.9. Practical value of V reference is how much? From the figure, you can observe that. So now I am going to give you the demo regarding your non-inverting symmetrical. This is inverting one, guys. You can design the circuit like this. Better you take the snapshot of it, and you may take 10k also. If suppose you are taking 10k and 1k, it's okay. If you are taking 27k and 1k also, it is okay, no issue, but output should come. Okay, guys, this is regarding the bias. Do you have any doubt, miss? You may ask.
Ma'am, I'm sure, like, it's not visible. Yeah.
Hemant, I should not show you. This is the lab task. No, you should design that. Hemant?
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah. You should refer your theory. It is nothing big in that. If you did. Yeah, bias, because after designing the inverting symmetry, no, additionally you use the bias value as okay. I don't want to put the burden upon you. Otherwise, actually this is the procedure. I should not show the circuit to you. You have to only design. I should give
ma'am,
you the question.
Bias value, we have to put also, we have to design, ma'am.
Yeah, you have to decide. Suppose I'm going to give 1.5. If you are going to take 2 volt, what will be the output? One type of question is given in the theory also. If you remember in the last class, I had given a question also. In that UTP and LTP was given, R1, R2 is not given, but you can relate that question to your part also. Question was given in your theory. The same thing we are going to do in the lab class. Okay, guys, already I have done the circuit for you. I'll just share my screen. Yeah, now tell me what type of symmetrical have been projected for you.
Non-inverting.
Non-inverting symmetrical. What are the VCs or DC voltage value I have taken at here? Power supply is
15 plus minus 15.
Plus minus 15, right? Okay. So let's see what type of output do we get. I have used V in and V out, guys, to show you the hysteresis point. You can directly connect that power supply and ground type also. That is also working. So because I have used the VCC voltage, I have to use the at trace option to show you the input. So these are the procedure we are following, right? I have to keep the analog and voltages only. V in I want to see. So this is my applied V in for 2.5 volt, right? plus minus 2.5 volts, see positive and negative. So up to 5 volt, see plus 2.5, minus 2.5. This is my applied input. Now I have to show you. Input is sinusoidal waveform. What should be my output from the symmetry trigger?
Square wave.
Now the red color is showing you the square waveform. So the symmetry trigger alone, it cannot give rise to you the exact square wave, but we can get it by adjusting the R1, R2 value and also by using the capacitor with square wave that you have learned in your theory class, right? We can adjust that. That also we are going to practice. That here. So here you can see input is sinusoidal waveform and output is the square waveform. Then what is the next job, guys? How do we check the reference voltage? I was telling you now, practically we have to get some value. I have told you now it should come some value. So go to toggle cursor, then cursor peak. See, at here it is shown some value are showing. No, V out value is 14.816. Okay. So this is your practical value. You can calculate your reference voltage by referring this V out value. Okay.
Ma'am, the hysteresis loop.
Guys, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
I connected through mobile only because power cut is at here, so my Wi-Fi signal gone. I'm just trying, just be patient.
Ma'am, can we show the last experiment?
Just wait, I have to carry on this class.
Now my voice is audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, so I was at here.
Yes, ma'am.
Up to this you got now. How do we generate? Okay. Up to this you got now?
Ma'am, your voice lagged in between. Could you please repeat again?
My voice lagged in between. Wait. Hmm. Is this clear again, my boys?
Yes, ma'am.
Huh. So the last output I have shown only. Up to this you got, na?
Yes, ma'am.
So the last step, this is carefully, you just, after generating the input-output waveform, what you have to do, these are my axis value, right? 0 second, 0.5 millisecond, 1 millisecond, and up to 5 millisecond, because I have given this value in that edit simulation window, that value I have entered. So these are the value. Now I have to show you the hysteresis value. What are the limitation of my input output range, and it will confine within the lower threshold and upper threshold value. So what I have to do, I have to click any of the value, any of the time span value, double click. Suppose I am clicking on 1.5 millisecond or 1 millisecond, any one value. My motive is to just directly, how do I get the axis setting option? Double click on it. See, axis setting will be available for you. It means if you click on the axis value, your axis setting for x-axis will be available for you. Okay. Then now look at your axis. So here I am going to show you the hysteresis curve for both the input and output. See, VR1 of 1, that I have to select and click OK. Again click OK. See, the hysteresis curve for the output is red color, for the input is green color. Okay. So both the things can be visible onto your screen, but now I want to show you the input and output hysteresis curve separately to you. Suppose I want to show you input only, I have to remove my output. So how do I do that step? If you just click on Vout, so I am doing, if you click that Vout, it will be turned bold red. If I will click Vin, it will be turned red. For what color it will come for you, you just check that. So it means my point of view is, which one we want to remove. We have, I want to remove V out. I will just show you V in with respect to x axis and V out with respect to y axis. Or in another word, I want to show you the hysteresis curve for V in and V out separately to you. Okay. So what do I do? I want to show you V in only. So I'll just delete the V out after select. When it will change to red, just press the delete key from your keyboard of the laptop. See, the Vin only will be available. You can see that this is the range of the Vin. In the left hand side, it will show you the range minus 4 volt. Here it is 4 volt. It means Vin with respect to x axis. Okay. The same way I'm going to show you the V out with respect to the y axis. Now I have to go for the previous simulation graph. Let's go to that trace, add trace, and V out. See, now I have to show you V out only. I have to delete the V in. Yeah, this is the representation of your V out. and this is all about hysteresis curve. How much theoretical value you have been calculated, you can check your threshold point. These are the threshold point. This is the plus minus V set level as per the graph I have shown in the PowerPoint presentation. As per that, you may calculate threshold voltage point. Somebody mute yourself. Who is this? Okay, guys. This is the procedure to get the
that how to change this axis UR1 double dot one you have done. Can you explain one more time?
That is to see at a time the graph. After that only I am deleting one by one. So first once again I have to run it. Okay. This is the circuit. After getting the circuit we have to run it. Run it as usual. So this window will appear for us. And here I have to bring the input output graph. So how do I do that? Trace V in, click OK. Then trace at trace V out, because I have leveled that VCC as V in and V out. Okay. Up to this you got, no?
Yes, ma'am.
After that, double click on this axis path, this segment. Okay, this area you just double click it. After this axis setting will appear. Otherwise, you may go. How we are getting axis setting from the plot? Axis setting also we are getting. Are you getting my point?
Yes, ma'am.
In this way also you may go. Either or way you may go. So these are the two options I have given. So after coming this axis setting variable with respect, I have selected alias for voltage. You can see the current alias are also there. You need not to select that. I need voltage alias for the input output hysteresis curve. So it is represented as V of R1 of 1. Okay. So click that, click OK. See, this is the procedure. And one more time, I'm just repeating once again. I need V in again. So delete V out by selecting V out and pressing the delete key from your keyboard. I can show you the V-in only. Similar plot, axis setting, axis variable. I want to show you the V-in. So V-out if you click. This is V-in only, guys. I have to run it once again. Then only I can show you by this method. One more minute. Trace, at trace, V in, okay. Trace, at trace, V out. Okay, I want to show you V out only. So I have to delete. Then hysteresis curve I have to plot. No, guys, it is not coming. I think I have to run it once again. I have to close this window.
Yes, ma'am. For me also, this straight line is coming.
It is not coming. Yeah, you have to run it properly and you have to delete the previous window because it is overlapping. Once and once I am repeating on the same window, na? That's
okay.
Why.
Okay.
Close it. Okay. Close it and run it and get the new window. It will come. Because first time it came for me, no? Address V out. Then Wait guys, I'm checking, but you refer the procedure. I'll tell you what is the glitch where it is lagging. I'll tell you, okay? I hope you understand the concept, how we have to do. I'll just verify and let you know. Okay, similarly, you go for the inverting and with the bias method of the symmetrical, you show it to me. Okay, proceed for that. Guys, are you doing that? Yes or no?
Ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, proceed.
Ma'am. Oh, ma'am.